Here we are on slide 59 of our PowerPoint slides. These are sample practice problems that I will work through numbers 1 and 3 that are bolded here. Notice number 2 I have crossed out in the interest of time and our situation this semester. I'm going to skip that one. Number 4 I will recommend that you work on your own, and then I have the solutions on the next slide in your file. Our first example is working with calcium fluoride. In this one, we are given the gram solubility, and recognize, of course, that gram is an optional word in here. If I just give you the solubility, it means the same thing. And we're asked to calculate the KSP for this salt. So remember the required steps for a solution, starting with our dissociation or dissolution equation. Remembering that because we're working with insoluble salts, they set up equilibrium. Calcium fluoride, of course, has a formula of CaF2, meaning that we dissociate into a calcium 2 plus ion and 2 fluoride ions. Our next required step is writing the equilibrium expression. Calcium 2 plus is first order and fluoride ion is second order. And as we saw in our shortcut version, we know that because the salt dissociates in a 1:2 ratio, our KSP equation solves out to be 4x cubed. That is sufficient amount of work there for my purposes. So to get full credit, that would be enough work there. You don't need to show the ice table. So we got all of that information just from the name. Now we come back to using our gram solubility. We're given a value of 0.016 grams per liter. And realize that if we want to solve for a KSP value, it means that we need to know a value of X. And of course, remember that X is molar solubility. That means that I need to determine the molarity, the moles per liter, that I have for this salt. And that means that I need to convert from grams to moles. And here again is where I'm using the molar mass of my entire salt. Because of course it's the whole salt that I would put in water, not one or both of the ions. For calcium fluoride, when we check its molar mass in our periodic table, calcium has a molar mass of 40.078 plus 2 fluoride ions at 18.998 we get a molar mass of 78.074 grams. This gives us a molarity of 2.0493 times 10 to the minus 4. And again, that is now in molarity. And that is my X value for these problems. To solve for the KSP then, I'm going to plug my X value into my 4X cubed equation. Problems like these are where we need to remember our order of operations. So exponents come first. I'm going to cube my X value first and then multiply by 4 to give me a KSP value of 3.4. I need 2 sig figs because of my solubility that was given. 3.4 times 10 to the minus 11. Another reminder that because I've calculated an equilibrium constant, that is unitless, so I just need to worry about sig figs here. In this video, I will also work through problem number 3 from that previous screen. In this example, similar to the first one we worked with silver bromide, we're given the KSP and asked to calculate the molar and the gram solubility here. But I wanted to work this problem because it's not a 1:1 ratio, and again, to review our order of operations. Going through our required steps, we have our formula for iron 3 hydroxide, FeOH3. That is the solid. that dissociates in equilibrium into iron with a 3+ charge and 3 hydroxide ions with a -1 charge. My KSP expression here is the iron 3+ ion concentration with an exponent of 1, my hydroxide concentration with an exponent of 3, and because this salt dissociates in a 1:3 ratio, we can either solve for or remember that our KSP expression or equation comes out to be 27x⁴. Again, paying attention to what we are given, we're told the KSP value, and so it means this equation of 27x⁴ is set equal to 4.0 times 10 to the minus 38. And before we calculate, I want you to estimate your number that you should get for your final answers. Realize that a KSP of 10 to the minus 38 means that this salt doesn't dissociate or dissolve. We should get extremely small values for the molar and the gram solubility then. To find our molar solubility, we are solving for x. I'm using this mathematical equation of 27x⁴ set equal to our KSP value. And again, remember our order of operations. I need to divide by 27 first. So x⁴ is then equal to 1.48 times 10 to the minus 39. And now I need to take the fourth root of this value to solve for x. Here is where I encourage you to make sure you know how to take the fourth root of a number. One option in your calculator, if you don't have a specific root button, is to use the caret and then raise it to the 1 divided by 4. So you would enter your number here, caret and 1 divided by 4, or of course 0.25. So make sure you know how to use your calculator for these. What you should be getting then for your value of x is 1.9619 times 10 to the minus 10 molar. Again, using extra digits here, I'm going to report final answers later. And to make my next step easier, I'm actually going to write molarity out as moles per liter so I can remember my next step. So again, here I need to use the molar mass of my salt. When we calculate all of that out, we get a molar mass of 106.875. So multiplying our value of x times our molar mass, we get a gram solubility of 2.09677 times 10 to the minus 8 grams per liter. Noting our final answers, x is, with sig figs, a 2.0 times 10 to the minus 10 molar, or you can write that out as moles per liter. It is also 2.1 times 10 to the minus 8 grams per liter. And so those would be your final answers for the molar and gram solubility.